Weak acids and weak bases are weak because they do not form 100% products because they are equilibrium reactions. And so what we're going to look at in this module is we're going to look at acid-base equilibria as it relates to weak acids and weak bases. We are 100% going to be looking at aqueous solutions, which means there is water as the solvent, which means we really have to take into account the role of water in these acid-base equilibria reactions. So let's look at water. Back in Chem 1, we talked about electrolytes versus non-electrolytes, and one thing we learned is that water is a non-electrolyte because there are no ions in a pure sample of water. We were sort of lying to you, because what happens in water is that water undergoes a very slight reaction with itself to form the hydronium ion and the hydroxide ion. This equilibrium reaction is present in a sample of pure water. What's happening is one of the water molecules is accepting a proton from the second water molecule or from a neighboring one. The one that accepts the proton becomes H3O plus. The one that donates the proton becomes OH minus. So water is undergoing an acid-base reaction with itself. We call this auto-ionization. And there are ions in a sample of pure water. But the thing is there are very, 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 very few of these ions because the equilibrium constant for this particular reaction, which is products over reactants raised to the stoichiometric coefficients. So I'll have my H3O plus times my OH minus. Those are aqueous. I will not divide by any H2Os because the pure liquids, so it's just this. The value, the numerical value for this equilibrium constant at 25 degrees Celsius, which is room temperature, is 1.0 times 10 to the minus 14. That is 0.0000. It is that numerical value. So that is my equilibrium constant, which means this is a very reactant favored reaction. There are very few products, and because of the stoichiometry of it, we will have exactly equal amounts of H3O plus and OH minus. So I could call that amount X, so X H3O plus concentration, X OH minus concentration equals 1 times 10 to the minus 14. And solving for X, take the square root, you get 1 times 10 to the minus 7. And so the concentration of H3O plus, which is equal to the concentration of OH minus in pure water at 25 degrees Celsius, is 1 times 10 to the minus 7 molarity. It is a very, very small amount of ions, and for that reason, water is considered a non-electrolyte. However, if you're dealing with acids and bases, recall from our definition, an Arrhenius acid produces the hydronium ion, an Arrhenius base produces the hydroxide ion, so you can't really ignore hydronium ion and hydroxide ions that are there to begin with. Besides that, these guys participate in the equilibrium with the weak acids and the weak bases, and so they become important as we start talking about acids and bases. Just to clean this up, a couple of notations. This equilibrium constant for the auto-ionization of water is often written with a little W subscript on the equilibrium constant symbol for water. And so this is called the KW for water. It is the equilibrium constant for that reaction. And we often abbreviate H3O plus as simply H plus. And so it is an acceptable way to abbreviate H3O plus is to call it H plus. And so we will often see this bottom equation for the KW of water. And again, at 25 degrees Celsius, it is 1 times 10 to the minus 14. Now, this equilibrium constant for water works for all aqueous solutions. So if I have an acid solution, that means that I have added something to water that produces more hydronium ions or produces more hydrogen ions. So in an acidic solution, the H plus concentration will get bigger. It will increase because that's what an acid does. The OH minus concentration will get smaller because H plus times OH minus is still going to equal 1 times 10 to the minus 14. So in an acidic solution, the H plus concentration will be greater than the OH minus. In an acidic solution, there still will be some hydroxide ion. It will just be an incredibly small amount. In a basic solution, a base is something that when you put it in water, it produces hydroxide ions. So in a basic solution, the hydroxide ion concentration will get bigger. The hydrogen ion concentration will get smaller. There will still be some H plus in the solution if it's basic. It's just that it's going to be a really, really small amount. These two are equal in a neutral solution. We wrote that up here, but I didn't label it. This is neutral. In an acidic solution or a basic solution, we now have these relationships between H plus and OH minus. We can put some numbers on this, so let me get some space and we'll do some numbers. All right, so we have that H plus times OH minus equals 1 times 10 to the minus 14. That is true for any aqueous solution. So if I have an aqueous solution where I know the hydrogen ion concentration, I can calculate the OH minus concentration and vice versa. For example, let's say I have a solution where the H plus concentration is equal to 2.5 times 10 to the minus 8 molarity. Just pulling a number out of my hat. All right, so that means the OH minus concentration in that solution would be 1 times 10 to the minus 14 divided by 2.5 times 10 to the minus 8. So my solution has an H plus of 2.5 times 10 to the minus 8 and an OH minus of 4 times 10 to the minus 7. As we saw on the previous screen, if the OH minus is greater than 1 times 10 to the minus 7, the solution is basic. And so I can conclude that this solution is a basic solution. So in a basic solution, since the OH minus is greater than the H plus, the OH minus concentration is going to be greater than 1 times 10 to the minus 7 molarity. The H plus concentration, likewise, will be less than 1 times 10 to the minus 7 molarity. In an acidic solution, on the other hand, since I have an increase in H plus, the H plus concentration will be greater than 1 times 10 to the minus 7 molarity, and the OH minus concentration will now be less than 1 times 10 to the minus 7 molarity. In this solution that I used in my example, the H plus was 2.5 times 10 to the minus 8, which is actually smaller than 1 times 10 to the minus 7. You have to worry a little bit about your negative exponents. This is actually smaller than, less than 1 times 10 to the minus 7. And so this agrees with the fact that this is a basic solution. If you have a basic solution, your H plus concentration and OH minus concentration will both agree with these statements right here. If you have an acidic solution, your H plus concentration and OH minus concentration must both be in agreement with these inequalities. And so from one, you can calculate the other in any solution. And again, what we see is that if it is a basic solution, we do have more OH minus. If it is an acidic solution, we have more H plus. You should practice with these calculations because you will see some on quizzes and tests. But as you might note from what we did here, working with negative exponents is kind of painful. And so what scientists have done is they have invented something called the pH scale. The pH of a solution is the negative logarithm, and this is the log base 10, not the natural log, of that H plus concentration. So if I plug in the H plus concentration, I take the negative log of it, make sure that you can do that on your calculator. My numerical value that I solve for will be the pH. If I have a neutral solution, the H plus concentration is equal to 1 times 10 to the minus 7. And so the pH of a neutral solution is the negative log of 1 times 10 to the minus 7. If you plug that into your calculator, you find that your pH, it comes up as exactly 7. If I can say a little bit about sig figs, and we'll practice this as we do more problems. When you're using logarithms, the significant figure rules are new. They're not like the significant figure rules we learned when we were adding, subtracting, multiplying, and dividing. The way that they work is when I take the log, either the natural log or the log base 10, so this works back in the kinetics chapter 2. If I take the natural log of a number with two sig figs, my 1.0 times 10 to the minus 7 has two sig figs, then my answer, the answer of the log, should have two decimal places. So if I take the log of a number with two sig figs, my answer will have two decimal places. So a neutral solution has a pH of 7. A neutral solution has a pH of 7. In our example up above, in our basic solution up above, we had the H plus was equal to 2.5 times 10 to the minus 8. And so for that basic solution, the pH of it is the negative log of 2.5 times 10 to the minus 8. And if you punch that into your calculator, you get 7.60. I took the log of a number that has two sig figs, therefore my answer has two decimal places. A basic solution will have a pH that is greater than 7, and alternatively, an acidic solution will have a pH that is less than 7. There's a picture of your pH scale in your textbook. You might want to get used to the way it works. It essentially goes from 0 to 14, although we absolutely can have pHs that are less than 0, and we absolutely can have pHs that are greater than 14. Normally, we'll be working with pHs between 0 and 14. Exactly halfway in between at a pH of 7, we're talking about our neutral solution. Greater than 7 is basic, less than 7 is acidic.